Major news this week marked the potential breakthrough for women with HIV. An American mixed-race woman battling leukemia is possibly the third patient and first woman cured of the virus. Now, doctors used a new stem cell transplant procedure, which is deemed to be less invasive and accessible to more people. Now, that could have a big impact. Nearly 1.2 million Americans have HIV, and it continues to disproportionately affect people of color. Joining me now is one of the members of the research team, Dr. Marshall Glesby, Associate Chief of the Infectious Disease Division at Weill Cornell Medicine. Thank you so much for being here, Doctor. This is so fascinating. When I was reading about this, I was very confused and fascinated at the same time. So tell our viewers what this means exactly. Is there now an official cure for HIV, or was there something about these three individuals that allowed them to show no detectable signs of the disease?
I think it's important to note that this is really not a procedure or a way to cure people with HIV in general. The three people to date, including our patient that we reported this earlier this week, were people who needed a stem cell or bone marrow transplant for a specific condition like leukemia, blood cancer, or lymphoma. And as part of that procedure, they were transplanted with cells that were resistant to HIV. Later down the road, our patient able to interrupt HIV therapy and maintain control of the virus.
So, Dr. Glesby, in some of the reading, it was suggested that racial ethnicity may have had something to do with that. Is that accurate?
Well, I think the angle here, there's really two aspects to it for our particular patient, who, as you noted, identifies as mixed race. The cells that are resistant to HIV, a natural genetic variation that occurs in probably less than 1% of people, and primarily people of Northern European ancestry. So when someone needs a transplant like this, they need to be matched with the donor cells. And because of that, it could be much more difficult for somebody who is not of European ancestry to find a match. But because we use umbilical cord cells for the transplant, they don't need to be matched quite as rigorously, would broaden the possibility that you would have a donor cells from vocal cord that actually contain this genetic variation referring to HIV. I think the other important angle is that people with HIV are disproportionately, or people with color are disproportionately affected by HIV in this country, and the majority of people living with HIV in the world are in sub-Saharan Africa. And also our patient, as you noted, is a woman, and we know that over half of people throughout the world with HIV are women, and in this country, about one quarter. And I think this really relates to issues of inclusivity and equity, that a woman of color, in this case, enrolled in a clinical trial, was able to access this investigation.
So I was going to ask why people of color, particularly Black people who are over-indexed when it comes to new HIV cases, but I think you answered that question, so thank you for that. Something else I want to shift gears. A significant portion of transmissions are now from straight people, which is interesting. I think this is the first time in history this has happened. Any idea why the FDA still sets certain regulations on gay men being able to donate blood? I think right now they have to wait 3 months if they've had sex with another man, they can't donate blood. If the new cases are more from straight people, why does that rule exist? Any thoughts there?
Well, I think the FDA has been revisiting this, and other countries have removed those types of barriers for people who have sex with men from donating blood or blood products. And part of it is we really have excellent tests that are very sensitive at detecting traces of HIV in the bloodstream. So there really shouldn't be any reason, in my mind, to exclude people based on those types of behaviors.
Well, we'll definitely keep our eye on this development. I appreciate you've made it very digestible for our viewers, so I appreciate that, Dr. Glesby. And this research is quite fascinating. So anytime you have updates, we'd love to have you back on the Cross Connection. Thanks so much.